third thing is that he was quite present. Salim Adam Aziz, Salim Sinha's grandfather, he was present in Amritsar during the time of Jallianwala Bagh massacre. If we compare these events with the life of Jawaharlal Nehru, then we can say that Jawaharlal Nehru also belonged to Kashmir. He was a Kashmiri man. Like Adam Aziz, he has been educated in Europe. At the same time, we can say that it is he who welcomed the knowledge of English language to India, as well as the knowledge of science and technology to India. Another important thing is that Jawaharlal Nehru was also quite present during the time of Jallianwala Bagh Hatyakand in Amritsar. So this is a significant similarity that we observe between the two, Adam Aziz, Salim Sinha's grandfather, and Jawaharlal Nehru. So in that way, we can say, you know, the plot operates at literal level. We will find the story of Salim Sinha and his family, whereas at implied level, it talks about the story of Jawaharlal Nehru. Another thing is that, yes, the education of English language. During the first half of the 20th century, Britishers have covered almost 190 countries of the world. They had been ruling over the world. But 20th century proved to be the sudden demise of the British colonial power, and the period of decolonization begins. Now, Britishers realize that it will be next to impossible to rule over these countries physically. And so, the British government has formulated a new policy. They have introduced a new institution or organization, I should say, with the name Commonwealth Group of Nations. And those countries who were formerly under the rule of British government, they were asked to join hand this Commonwealth Group of Nations. At that time, the proposal came to India also. Jawaharlal Nehru, who was a responsible person to take decision, and he willingly expressed, or he joyously decided to be the member of Commonwealth Group of Nations. But let me tell you, during those days also, there were two poles of opinions. Krishna Menon and the other experts, they were saying that joining this organization would be accepting slavery once again. But Jawaharlal Nehru, on the contrary, remarked that English is the window of the world. It is with the help of the English language, India will keep itself updated in future. And this is what we see today. So Jawaharlal Nehru expressed the optimistic way to join this organization, and the English learning started in India. In the fiction, of course, there is no reference of this particular incident, but we can say that in this fiction, there are some people who are becoming white. They were identified as the white-skinned people. And this is a metaphor. Why are they called white-skinned people? Because by receiving the knowledge of English language, they are under the influence of westernization. So this is the point of comparison. Allegorically, it is presented in the fiction. Another thing is that we are aware of the Jallianwala Bagh massacre. It was the eve of Vaishakhi, and in Amritsar, the mob has gathered together, and Jallianwala Bagh was the place. But unfortunately, with the order of General Dyer, the rest of the police officers, they arrested that castle, and constantly they kept on firing on the mob without giving any instruction, and down about 1650 bullets were fired. And let me tell you, 1560 people were killed. during this Jallianwala Bagh massacre. Now, in the fiction, we will find that Adam Aziz, he is the follower of one of the persons, Mia Abdullah. And he happens to have the narrow escape in Jallianwala Bagh massacre. He receives a bullet, but unfortunately, he is simply hurt. He doesn't get killed. But he says that the way he has been hurt, that bruise, that wound is never going to get healed. So, allegorically, we can say that India has also received that wound, and that is a stigma on Mother India's forehead, which is never going to be forgotten at any cost in future. This is another point of comparison, that Adam Aziz becomes the part of that Jallianwala Bagh massacre. He was the eyewitness, and he was the, you know, he had the narrow escape in that. Another point of similarity is that, you can look at this slide. The situation of emergency. National emergency has been declared by Indira Gandhi, who by that time receives the crown of India. And national emergency was declared. This national emergency can be understood as the political child of Indira Gandhi. Why? Because Parvati, who happens to be one of the characters of this fiction, she gives birth to a baby on the same day when Indira Gandhi declares national emergency. So the birth of the baby and Indira Gandhi's declaration of national emergency are interwoven together. So this is another point of comparison allegorically presented in the fiction. One more important thing is that you can look at the color of her hair. Many critics have interpreted that the white patch of her hair shows the merit of the national emergency, whereas many critics have interpreted that the black color of her hair has demerits of emergency. Mother India has, you know, white and black hair. It means emergency has its merits and its demerits. This is what we will have to understand. Everything is presented in the fiction, but I should say once again, it is allegorically presented. When we read this fiction, we will make ourselves familiar with the utmost details. Going ahead, I would say one more important point of discussion is that yes, in those days India name was not there. The whole subcontinent was known as Hindustan. There were two groups. One is favored by Muslim League, who followed the ideology of Muhammad Ali Jinnah, who demanded the separate existence of Pakistan from India. And another is Free Islam Convocation, who did not support the demand of Muhammad Ali Jinnah. The Free Islam Convocation said that this Bangladesh and Pakistan, they were the two limbs of Mother India. They can never be separated from India at any cost. Here, in the fiction, we will find that Salim Sinai's grandfather, Adam Aziz, he is the follower of Mia Abdullah. And Mia Abdullah supported the ideology of Free Islam Convocation. And this ideology says that ideology demands united India. But unfortunately, it so happens that Mia Abdullah has been assassinated. He was killed brutally, and that is with the help of the knife. And he was, you know, killed in such a way that one of his assistants, Nadir Khan, who happens to be the witness of that particular murder, and he runs away from the place. But let me tell you, with the death of Mia Abdullah, the hope of united India comes to an end. This is allegorically presented in the fiction. So these are certain issues. Something more. There is one more point of comparison between Jawaharlal Nehru and Adam Aziz. Adam Aziz happens to, while praying to Lord, when he was offering his namaz, he happens to stumble his nose onto the ground, and as a result of this, three drop of blood drop onto the ground, and this is the incident from where onwards he has lost his faith from the religion. So we can say Jawaharlal Nehru also, he has also lost the faith from his father, and Adam Aziz has also lost his faith from the religion. This is another incident. The one more important thing is that when the fiction gets open, the first chapter is Perforated Seat. The title is given Perforated Seat. Adam Aziz, being a doctor, he examines one of the patients, and the name of the patient is Naseem Ghani. Now Naseem Ghani, she lives in Kashmir. There was one boatman called Tai. He used to welcome Adam Aziz every day, and Ghani, who happens to be the father of Naseem Ghani, now that father pretends to be blind. He wanted that Adam Aziz, a doctor, to get married with his own daughter Naseem Ghani, but he plays the role of a blind man, and he calls for the help of the doctor. Adam Aziz goes to the place of Naseem Ghani, but as per the rule, as it is mentioned in the fiction, that the whole body of Naseem Ghani has been covered with a sheet, that is a perforated sheet, and in the middle of that sheet there was a hole approximately 7 centimeters, and through that hole the doctor is supposed to assess the body of Naseem Ghani. The doctor doesn't see her face for a longer period of the time, and since the father was blind, the doctor considers its pious responsibility and goes to assess the patient. But you know, the way he used to assess Naseem Ghani with the help of that hole, 7 centimeters hole, that exposed part of the body keeps on haunting his memory, and slowly and gradually he started feeling for Naseem Ghani. He develops love with Naseem Ghani. Another incident is that once upon a time Naseem Ghani suffers from a severe headache, and during this time Adam Aziz was called. Adam Aziz for the first time happens to see the face of his beloved Naseem Ghani, and he further falls in love with her. This is the day when the First World War comes to an end. So historical event is once again connected with the event of an individual's life. So Adam Aziz happens to see the face of his beloved Naseem Ghani on the day where First World War comes to an end. Now Naseem, she gets married with Adam Aziz, and both of them, they have 4 children, 3 daughters and a son. And in this fiction we see that after the death of Mia Abdullah, Nadir Khan escapes from the spot, and he has taken his shelter in the basement of Adam Aziz's house. Now Adam Aziz gives him shelter because both of them, they have the same ideology. Nadir Khan was also the supporter of Free Islam Convocation, and Adam Aziz was also the follower of Mia Abdullah. So on that cause, he gives shelter to Nadir Khan. Now the mother has naturally opposed this because she was living with her three daughters. So she says that just for the sake of the safety of the daughters, let us not allow this Nadir Khan to stay in basement. But Adam Aziz doesn't listen to her and gives him a shelter. Now Nadir Khan happens to fall in love with one of the daughters, Mumtaz. And mother once again had a quarrel with father, that in spite of the denial, you have given shelter to Nadir Khan, and now he has developed relationship with her daughter. All of them, they give permission, and Nadir Khan and Mumtaz, they get married with each other. But Adam Aziz, being a doctor, realizes that in spite of spending 3 years together, Mumtaz doesn't remain pregnant. It proves that Nadir Khan is impotent. And Nadir Khan, on one fine morning, writes a cheat that I divorce you, and then he leaves Mumtaz. Now, Mumtaz, she happens to get married with Salim. And Salim Sinai, happens to get married with Ahmed Sinai. And Ahmed Sinai, both of them, Mumtaz and Ahmed Sinai, they had a child who is known as Salim Sinai in the fiction. Now Nadir Khan, who runs away from the place. So there was a quarrel between grandfather and grandmother, Adam Aziz and Naseem Ghani. Adam Aziz asked her to keep mum. For 3 years, she keeps mum and she doesn't talk to the husband. But the moment Nadir Khan leaves the place, gives divorce to her daughter, she started abusing the father like anything. And when she's, you know, these.